No, I think it's more of a yeast infection, really. Okay, well, if I stand over a mirror, I suppose I can take a look. Okay. Hello, I'm Ben Turner, and I'm the drummer of the Holloway Echoes.
Hi, I'm Pat. Pat Wynn, singer with the Holloway Echoes.
Hi, I'm Alan. I play guitar, a bit of Hammond organ, a bit of piano, bits and pieces in the Holloway Echoes.
I am Nick. I am the bass player for the Holloway Echoes.
So we've just finished making our second album, and we're very pleased with it. It's called Stack 'Em Up, and it'll be out on July the 10th. So we just thought we'd make a little video and tell you a little bit about the new album and how it was made.
Pat and Alan had written some great material. We had a lot of fun with all the Chaz and Dave things as well.
I'm not sure there's anything good I can say about lockdown, really.
For me, it was 3 or 4 days on my own in a room with my drums, communicating through the talk back on the desk to Alan, Pat, and Nick.
Anyway, the results speak for themselves, I think. As always, I'm very, very, very proud of the results that we've got.
Great, good fun. It was lovely.
I feel sorry for Ben in a lot of ways because you see, the drums are the foundation of everything. Now, we're often throwing songs at Ben, and it's the first time he's heard the song, and yet he's expected to record it. So all those recordings that you hear with Ben Turner playing drums on, that's a recording of him learning the song. But Ben can cope with that, and I've known Ben a long, long time, and I've got absolute faith in him that he'll always pull it off, and he does. That's Ben Turner.
Very lucky to play alongside all these great musicians and great guys, actually, which is just as important. Great senses of humour. We have a laugh or two. Ben should be in the fast show, I've decided. And of course, he's an excellent drummer.
Ben Turner, he made such a difference to the contribution I was able to give to the album, because locking in with Ben's drums, I can't sing the man's praises highly enough. Brilliant, brilliant man, brilliant drummer, and a joy to work with.
Nick is a great guitar player, but he mainly plays bass in Holloway Echoes, and it's become almost tradition now that we let him loose on an instrumental or two. And he's done two on this album, which are absolutely staggering. They're breathtaking. He's really excelled himself, so he plays pretty much all the instruments, apart from drums, on the two instrumentals.
Nick, excellent musician. Turn his hand to anything.
Great bass player. He needs to remember, actually, in this band, he's the bass player. Never really quite sure what to say about Cliff without sounding totally soppy, because I honestly love the guy. He's like the nicest man.
Cliff Hall. There are no words to express his musicianship and caliber.
When you add Cliff Hall into that mix, you hopefully end up with a pretty good sound.
Very good, very good. Western Star is a great studio, great little studio. Alan Wilson runs it. And all the boys, Ben on drums and Nick McNulty and Alan Wilson and Pat, they're all good pals. And the recording techniques are different now. It's a lot easier to record, I think, nowadays to the old days.
He can pretty much play any style well, and his music theory and knowledge is like second to none. He's been a top session player all his life. And add to all that, chatting to the guy and hearing some of these stories.
I worked with Cliff before I met the Shadows, before I met Hank or Bruce, because I used to do session work with Brian Bennett. And Brian suggested to Cliff that he get me on keyboards. I used to do a lot for CBS in those days with Brian Bennett, you know, we both as session musicians.
The experience of working with Cliff is second to none. It's just fantastic.
Of course, Alan, apart from being an excellent musician, is the kind of glue that holds everything together.
Alan, a wonderful producer, a wonderful musician and songwriter, and very tolerant of me doing my stuff in the studio. He helped me no end, and the ideas he put forward into some of the, you know, some of the songs that I'd done, just brought them to life.
Yeah, you know, the effort that Alan's been to on this one can't really be understated. That's been a heck of a task for him, and we thank him for persevering. He must have felt like tearing his hair out at times with all our to-ing and fro-ing and the lockdown making life difficult, but he persevered, and we're very grateful for that.
I always really enjoy working with Pat. He's got a great voice, that guy, and he writes some really good songs. I'm a big fan of his songwriting, and that became apparent to me the first time I met him, which was, I don't know, 3 or 4 years ago.
Pat, great singer-songwriter, rockabilly king, and a wonderful storyteller, fantastic frontman.
Initially, I thought it was just a one-off, because I thought the last album was complete, if you know what I mean. It was a whole thing in its own right. And I was a little hesitant when I, you know, heard that it was being talked about to do a second one, because I thought, well, without wishing to seem sort of big-headed, I thought the first album was really, really good, and you know, you maybe should leave some things where they are and not revisit them. But when I heard the material for this one, I was just blown away. You know, the writing is so, so good, and I couldn't be happier with it. So, you know, when I heard the demos, I was really eager to crack on and you know, do the whole thing again, because working with these guys is just it's fabulous. It's something that I feel very lucky and privileged to have been part of.
Favourite songs? Yeah, this one's easy. Without doubt, Bridego. Bridego is another storytelling song that follows on from the Murder in Soho, the Murder in Soho song that Alan wrote. He wrote Bridego. It's a song about the one member of the great train robbery who was never caught.
It's hard to pick a favourite for me on this album. I like them all, but if I had to, I'd say a song that Pat wrote is a really cool song, Calling Buddy. And it's about Joe Meek, really, spiralling into some kind of madness in his later life. And Joe Meek used to try and contact Buddy Holly to ask for sort of guidance, ask for help when his career was failing. So it's quite a sad song, really, but quite interesting. And I think, you know, Pat wrote some great songs, and I think this is one of his best.
Tricky. I had a couple of firm favourites on the last album. On this one, I'm not sure that I could pick one. Nick's done a couple of great instrumentals. Probably for me, just because I love the comedy element, it'll be the Dinner Lady Rock and Roll. I love that song.
I really, really like Lost in London. I love that sort of 60s underground jazz feel. That's great. Calling Buddy makes the hairs on the back of my neck stand up. Yeah, another goodie. And a sort of real riot. I love Johnny Watts because it's just, I don't know, to me it sounds like a bit of an anthem.
Lockdown. It's had his frustrations for us. It's caused a few problems. And poor old Pat's had to drive probably about 2,000 miles. Because normally we would all converge on the studio, work for a week and then go home. Pat's had to come down 3 times, but he lives in the ass end of Norfolk. So he's about 250 miles away, probably longer, further than that.
All right then, as every T4 owner knows, the main excitement of owning one of these is just wondering if it will start or not. Here we go.
let's roll.
We're very fortunate that Alan has a huge book of contacts for musicians who he can call in for other sessions. And, you know, this one being no exception, we've got great backing vocals, fantastic Don Lusher trombone on Lost in London, piano, violin, and it just really, you know, adds to the whole process and makes the end product so varied, and I'd love it. It's really, really good.
And now they're all done in the bag, all you can hope for is that someone else is going to get it, and that really is the most important thing ever, that someone else will say, yeah, get that. And if that happens, then it's job done.
Well, my hopes for the second album are, you know, really just to follow on the success of the first album. We were all genuinely surprised by the wonderful reception that the first album received. It did go down well.
I want to just end by saying thanks to everyone who bought the first album. Your support really means everything to us. And the feedback was really, really good. So I thank you all for that. And hopefully, if you do buy this new album, you'll enjoy it. Really hope so.
Are the pubs open yet?
When I was a lad at Old Shit. When I was a lad at Old Shit. When I was a lad at Old
And what have I achieved from the Holloway Echoes, you may ask? I don't know. It's very difficult to get the amount of success that you hope you're going to get. But with the royalties, yeah, don't tell anybody how well I did. This is Sicily. This is beautiful. And this is where, thanks to the Holloway Echoes, I have now ended up.